Hello friends, in this session I have discussed on depth first search algorithm in artificial intelligence. Before starting this session, I tell you friends, in last session I explained breadth first search algorithm. This both algorithm comes under uninformed search technique. So I have start discussing on depth first search algorithm. DFS is an algorithm used for performing an uninformed search through tree or graph data structure. Depth first search algorithm start with the initial node of the graph or tree and then goes to deeper and deeper until we find the goal node or the node which has no children. The algorithm then backtrack from the dead end toward the most recent node that is yet to be completely unexplored. Here, the word backtrack means that when you are moving forward and there are no more nodes along the current path, you move backwards on the same path to find node to traverse. All the nodes will be visited on the current path till all the unvisited nodes have been traversed, after which the next path will be selected. This recursive nature of DFS can be implemented using LIFO stacks. The basic idea is as follows. Pick a starting node and push all its adjacent node into a stack. Pop a node from stack to select the next node to visit and push all its adjacent node into a stack. Repeat this process until the stack is empty. So here I have explained the basic information of depth first search algorithm. Now I discuss on key points of DFS algorithm, and its DFS has uninformed search algorithm. DFS use LIFO stacks. DFS follow deepest node for path finding. DFS has incomplete. DFS not provide optimal solution. I discuss this point one by one. First point is DFS has uninformed search algorithm. I explain this point with example. First, I select informed search techniques. For that, I have start node S and goal node G and one of the intermediate node A. With the help of intermediate node, I can reach to goal node. So in informed search, we can know in which coast we have reached S to A, and we can also know in which coast A can reach to goal node in advance. So this is called informed search technique. But in uninformed search, we can only know in which coast we have reached start node S to intermediate node A. But we cannot know in which coast our intermediate node A is reached to goal node G. So we can say that uninformed search algorithm do not have additional information about state or search space other than how to traverse the tree or graph. So it is called blind search. Second point is LIFO stack. LIFO means last in, first out, and it use data structure in stack. Stack by default work in LIFO technique. I apply this LIFO technique in this tree for DFS. In stack, we have insert the element with the help of push method, and we can remove element with the help of pop method. I explain this technique with example. I start with node A. So we have two child node of A and its B and C node. So we can insert in stack B and C node sequence or C and B node sequence. Here we have follow B and C node sequence. So in this sequence we can push C node last. So we can pop C element from the stack first. So here our sequence for search is A to C. Now see here, C has also two child node F and G. So we can push that element in stack. In stack we have already B element. So next we have insert F and G element. Now here we can push G in last. So we can pop G from the stack. So our sequence of search is A to C, C to G. Now see here, G node has no child node. So now we can perform backtrack. So G has go to his parent node C. Now node C has already cover. So we can pop F from the stack. So we can travel F node and our sequence of search is A to C, C to G, G to F. Now F node has no child node. So we can assign again, we can again perform backtrack. So F has parent node C. Node C has already cover. So we can move to parent node of C and it's A. Node A has already cover. So now we can pop B node from the stack and our sequence of search is A to C, C to G, G to F, F to B. Now see, node B has two child node E and D. So we can push the E and D element in the stack. Now we can push D element in the last. So we can pop the D element from stack. So our sequence is A to C, C to G, G to F, F to B, B to D. Now see here, D has no child node, so we can perform backtracking operation. So we can move parent node of B and its B element. Node B has already cover. So now we can pop the E element from the stack. So our search sequence is A to C, C to G, G to F, F to B, B to D, D to E. Now next point is DFS follow deepest node to find path. So if we have considered A has start node in this tree and we have following A to C and A to C, C to G sequence to find the goal node. So DFS follow this sequence until it reach to last node or goal node. So it's called deepest node sequence. Now, next point is DFS provide incomplete result. We have seen in DFS algorithm search like a shallowest node, or we can say it search level by level. So it 100% cover all the node in tree or graph. But in DFS algorithm search like deepest node. So suppose we have infinite search space in the problem or loop in the problem. So DFS algorithm cannot complete all the node, or we can say it follow wrong direction. So it not cover all the node and not to reach goal node. Now, next point is DFS not provide optimal solution. Optimal means provide a optimal path or shortest path to the cost when searching a state space for a path to a goal. DFS may provide a much longer path than EFS. I explain this point with example. If our goal node is E, but DFS can select A to C, C to G path. So it can follow this path until the last node. So this generate longest path compared to BFS, because BFS search in level wise level. So thank you friends watching this video. I hope you can understand all the point of DFS algorithm. Thank you.